Oh, before we start, I just need to say a couple of news. I started this new Back to Basics 3ds Max video series. It's pretty much for an absolute beginner, so if you know anyone who wants to learn 3ds Max, you know, maybe this is the place for that person. So if you go to my channel, is this Back to Basics Introduction to 3ds Max Part 1. Also, if you click on the playlist, this is the playlist for it. Learn 3ds Max from Zero to Hero. So yeah. Another update is for the workshop. It's being developed, so I didn't forget about it or anything. You'll know everything on time. And head over to RenderRam Instagram. This is where I pretty much post my daily researches, R&Ds. And you can generally, I don't know, see some funky stuff here. So yeah, RenderRam Instagram. Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna be showing you an upgrade to your wooden floors. So 2 years ago, I released this video, What Would Jesus Do? Materials episode 1, wood floors. In the meantime, I kind of developed some more techniques on how to enhance my wooden floors. So I'm gonna share those with you. One thing that whenever I would look at floors, like in real life floors, they would always be missing one key factor, and that's the human factor of people living in the space. So how do you know that your floor is, you know, quote unquote used? It's because of this. Wherever you walk, over time, your varnish on the floor will become more matte, but wherever you do not walk, it will stay shiny. So if you take a look at this image, you know, people have been living here, you know, minding their own business. It's all matte and stuff. But if you look at all the parts, like all the corners and that stuff, you can notice how the reflections are much sharper. Not only that, the useness, like whenever you use up the floor, not only that it alters the shininess, it also alters the color. So I'm going to be showing you this one method that I use to kind of add, you know, that certain extra kick to my floors. Let me just say this. I'm not going to be using any procedural dirts and stuff like that, because procedural dirts do not know where I've been walking. You don't know where I walk, only I know. The other example that I have here is this lovely room. And also what you can see is where, you know, people have been walking, you know, these parts of the floor are very blurry, where these parts, like nobody's been walking, you know, right next to the wall. These parts are, you know, very sharp. So I'm gonna be showing you two versions, like two methods on how you can achieve that effect. You know, both have pros and cons. So let's dive into it. So this is the room that I got. This is just an old interior that I, you know, revisited. I got a wooden floor, and my reflectivity is pretty much equal everywhere. When it comes to material, I have a diffuse map of the floor, I have some sort of reflection map, glossy map, and I have a bump. This technique, as usual, can be used in any rendering engine, and I do believe in any software, so yeah. So if you would go and try to dirt up your floors, you know, to get the shiny part, to get the, you know, non-shiny part, to get the dirty part, non-dirty, if you use some sort of procedural dirt, you know, like a dirt node in your material or something, you're gonna get the dirt node pretty much around all the corners, and, you know, you don't really have that human factor in it. So this is the thing that I do. Oh, by the way, there is some news. RenderRam channel just got a new sponsor. Bulls! Bulls are the crazy dudes that who created Scene Manager, Render Manager, Render Flow, Project Dream, Post Manager. But most importantly, there are some news about them, and they're giving away stuff for free. So for those of you who use Scene Manager and Render Manager, next week you're gonna get an update for V-Ray 7. Post Manager is now free to download. Also soon there will be a new version of Project Dream, which will include new prompt enhancer, reference library, and style transfer features. But wait, did I mention free stuff? If you go to Pool's website, and if you enter these codes, look, Scene Manager free for 14 days, Render Manager free for 14 days, Project Dream for 7 days. Just enter the codes, whether if you have the license or not, you're just gonna get extra stuff. So yeah, crazy times. Let's continue with the video. So this is the thing that I do. So on the floor, I would add subdivide. Why? Because I'm gonna be using vertex paint. The other method is without vertex paint, so yeah, buckle up. Subdivide. Let's say the number is gonna be 10. I think this is like a nice subdivision amount for this. So this is how we go about it. Go to your modifier list, type vertex paint,
click enter, you're gonna get this lovely little window here. Make sure that this version, like this option, is checked, and just click on the paint button. So now you're actually gonna be painting the mask on where the dirt is gonna be. Probably the best way to do that is, you know, just go to the top view, and you know, let's start from here. So this is how it goes. You pretty much just start painting. So you paint, you know, somebody's been sitting here, probably used up, you know, some flooring here, then here, you know, then somebody had to grab the remote because it was probably here. You have to grab something from the shelves. You're probably gonna walk in the back. People might, you know, be spending some time here. And this is generally like, just draw some logical paths, you know, this is the thing. I'm not going to be dealing with this room, so yeah, there you go. So this is our kitchen entrance. So here, you know, I'm just going to add, you know, some dirt there. So if I would have like a dining table here, I would probably, you know, do something like this, because, you know, below dining table, there's no that much, you know, usage of the floors. And, you know, since we have a door here, you can just, you know, make a path that goes here. So these are kind of, you know, the paths where people have been going. So I'm gonna go to my material editor, and I'm gonna add vertex color. Vertex color is generally available in every rendering engine. So you have it in V-Ray, Corona, Scanline, Arnold, everyone. So vertex color, let me fire up my rendering engine. Let's see what's happening with that. So when I resume my render here, and I'm just gonna plug it directly into the diffuse, this is the map that we got, and we're gonna be using this, you know, as our mask. Cool thing about it is, like, procedural dirt does not know that your legs have been here a lot. Procedural dirt also does not know that you've been using this part where the door is in the back because you were walking through the door. Get it? Organic touch. That's what we're looking at. Now, since this mask looks absolutely shitty, there is a cool button in our vertex paint, and that's this one, blur all. You also have a blur brush, but blur all will do the trick. So look at this. One blur all. Let's add another blur all, and let's try the third one. And this is our mask that we are generally working with. As you can see, the vertex color here, you know, this is our mask. So how do we use it with this diffuse texture? Through some sort of mix node. So this is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to add the mix node, and I'm going to plug in my vertex color into this mix node. I can now plug it directly into my diffuse. And now I can start plugging in my, you know, floor texture into one of these. By the way, this method can also be used with floor generator. So, you know, it's not purely plane based. Okay, so I'm going to plug this one here. And as we can see, this is the slot of our, let's call it, unused floor, or the brand new floor. Now, the one in the middle, I'm just going to add a color correction here, and just going to plug this one there, plug this one here. Now, do I need to brighten this up, darken this? This generally, you know, is depending on what type of floor do you have. You know, I have a floor at home, which, you know, when it gets dirty, it actually gets more pale, you know, because it's like a full matte floor or something, you know, stuff. But, you know, some other floors which have like more pronounced grain, they're actually going to accumulate a lot of dirt inside, and they're going to be actually darker. So just, you know, do a little bit of research. Which kind of dirt do you need? So I'm going to darken this one up. So let me set my offset to be 0.4. So you see, like, if I set it to zero, this is that. So offset is brightness. So let's keep that to 0.4, you know, just a little bit like that. Now let me go to my reflection. I can turn it on now. Glossy. Let's deal with glossy. It's pretty much the same thing. I'm going to do the same exact thing. It's just I'm going to be reusing the vertex color. So let me just move my bump here, and let's do it like this. Mix, plug in the vertex color. As we see here, the color correction here, this is me darkening the floor. And so the texture one is the part that's on the inside, like the dirty part. So I'm going to use my glossy texture, and I'm going to plug it into my clean part, and then add a color correction. And I'm gonna, I don't know, reduce gamma, let's say like that, 0.7 gamma, you know, just to kind of darken it up, maybe even more, let's go 0.5. Okay, now when I plug that into my glossy on my material, so this is the deal. Now, when you look at the whole image, you can notice, you know, of course, these parts are like very blurry, because if we just look at the mask that we have here, you know, all these are all blurry parts, right? But you can notice here, like around the sofa, we actually got some nice sharp reflections. We also have sharper reflections here, but here they're actually blurry because, you know, that's where somebody's been sitting. And now, because of this effect, we actually got that, you know, kind of human touch randomness to our image. Also, I can generally, you know, take this to the higher step. I could also I could also include that to the reflection, but I have a material where I actually did that. So you see, reflection, and this is the same thing just plugged into the reflection. So this is how the floor looks right now after our little vertex paint tweaks, and this is how the floor looked like when we started the video without any of that. As you can see, it just has a completely linear kind of, you know, feel to it, and I believe that this just kind of made it, you know, feel more organic, more relatable. I think this is the correct word. Now, let's switch to a night mode. Let's just see the effect there. So I'm gonna grab my lights, turn them on, and I'm gonna turn off the night, or turn on the night. Also the same thing. You can see like the reflection from the lights is like very blurry. You know, here we got a very sharp reflection from the sofa. If I move my camera around a little bit, you know, something like this, you can nicely see that we have a much sharper reflection from the light here. You know, these ones are more blurry. But the coolest thing is, whenever you want to kind of modify this, you pretty much just click on your floor and you just paint stuff like this. It's super easy. If you want to delete stuff, you have a razor brush, so you just erase things. You can use this technique generally on everything. It can be like on furniture, it can be on walls, wherever you want to add details. Now, let me just clarify one thing. Why is it important to have subdivide? For those of you who don't know, vertex paint kind of reacts with information per vertex or per polygon. If you have, you know, like a one plane, you know, with one polygon floor, vertex paint does not have anything to work with. These are pretty much the pixels, you know, think of it like that. These are like pixels in the 3D space. So he needs, you know, dots where he can paint stuff. Look, even on the complete night shot where I just have, you know, like a light in the kitchen, you can actually feel how this part is much more matte, where here a much stronger reflection kind of kicks in. You can actually feel how it's sharp and it's just getting more blurrier. I don't know, I think it's a cool effect. Now, another way how you can do this same effect is pretty much by painting this texture in Photoshop. So this is a pretty basic way on how you can do that. So look at this. If this is your floor, so as you can see, this is my floor, right? You can just grab a screenshot of that. Just click it right on the corners of the entire floor surface, which is here. Take that to Photoshop like this, and now you can just go to image size, increase the resolution a little bit, create a new layer, and just start painting. And now you can literally add the same effect. Once you're done, just create another layer, you know, below the image, like here, paint it white, export that and drag the texture directly into Photoshop. One thing that's very important is, since I have my UVW map here, which has a, you know, a specified length and width, just add another UVW map, which literally needs to look like this, because this is the screenshot that we took. Set that one to be map channel 2. And now, instead of the vertex color, you can just use this texture and it will be pretty much the same effect. Whoops, I forgot to set my map channel 2 on the in the image. And you're getting this. Now, pros and cons between, you know, the vertex paint method and the Photoshop method. With Photoshop, you can add much more high detailed textures, right? If you want to paint specific details, you can do that. But on the other hand, it's very flimsy. It's like you have to do the edit in Photoshop, then save it and import it and reload it, you know, then see how it looks like, etc., etc. Where with vertex paint, everything is directly in Max and you can just edit things on the fly, and it's super easy, it's super practical. Plus, it doesn't behave like a texture, meaning it actually renders faster. Because vertex paint, at the end of the day, is mesh data. And whatever comes from the core of the mesh has pretty much no render time. It's like instant render time. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope this was informational for you. And as usual, see you in the next one. Bye.